Hi guys, I'm Sonal and welcome to my channel. Today I'm making a lovely mousse cake. So this is a cake which is set using gelatin, and if you don't use gelatin, you could use agar agar for that. I have never used it successfully myself, so I can't advise you much on that. Anyway, this cake is very popular all over the net, and I've been watching the recipes and I've been watching all the videos where they cut it and it kind of slides down in a wave, and I was trying to get that effect, and I definitely got a lovely delicious mousse cake out of it. Try the recipe, you're going to love this. It is one of my favorites because any which ways I love desserts which have that kind of creamy and gelatiny texture, and it gives you that mouth feel, and it has a delicious chocolatey taste, so it's wonderful. And if you like the recipe, please click the like button, subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell on all notifications, and let's go ahead and see how I make this recipe. So here I have about 2 teaspoons of gelatin. I've used a tablespoon measure and I have gotten 1 teaspoon out of it. To this I'm adding 3 tablespoons of water. This is called blooming. So you add the water and let it sit for about 10 minutes and it'll plump up a little bit. And that's when the gelatin is ready to be used. This is 95% dark chocolate. It is unsweetened and it's a keto-friendly chocolate. It's a Lindt bar. I'm going to leave the links in the description. So if you want to buy it, you can buy it. I've taken the whole bar, which is about 80 grams. I'm going to break it into small pieces. You can definitely cut down on the quantity of the chocolate because the chocolate is expensive, and you can substitute with a little more cocoa powder and it will definitely work because this was an intense chocolatey flavor. If you guys don't need that, I would cut down on the chocolate to make it cheaper. I'm heating 1.5 cup of almond milk, 1 cup of heavy cream or fresh cream or whatever cream you guys use, 1/2 cup of swerve or any sweetener of your choice. You can use erythritol and a blend of stevia and erythritol or monk fruit sweetener. To this I've added 1/4 cup of cocoa powder. This is dark cocoa powder and it's a great brand. I love the smell of it. The taste is just like Hershey's, but when you smell it, it's a lot more chocolatey and I love it. I'm going to leave the link to that in the description too. We are going to mix all of this really well, and when the milk heats up or comes almost to a boil, everything will melt together and we are going to add our chocolate in. So this is the point where I'm adding all my chocolate in. It's going to melt into the mixture, and once that is done, we are going to add our gelatin. You don't want to boil your mixture after you've added the gelatin because that will actually affect the thickening power of the gelatin. Now once that is done and the gelatin has melted, so I switched off the gas. I'm going to strain this only because we're making a mousse cake and we are going to take pictures and hopefully share it on Instagram, and I want it to look good. But you guys at home could just leave this step out. It does help in making a much more silky and an even textured cake. I have poured all of my mixture through the sieve. I'm going to press it and try to make sure that I have taken each and every drop of that mixture. Don't waste anything. The chocolate is delicious. It's expensive. So I have scraped the bottom of the sieve too, and there is my lovely mixture. At this point, taste it and adjust the sweetness with stevia drops. Now we are going to cool it down. I have used some ice and water. I'm going to put this in a pot of ice and water, and once that has come to room temperature, I'm going to put this into a pan. So I have prepped a pan here. I have put some butter on the bottom and I have cut 2 parchment papers and placed it in a plus sign across so that all the sides of the pan are covered, and I have used clips to hold it in place. I'm going to pour my mixture inside and then get rid of the clips because they're going to just submerge in the mixture. And there you are. I somehow got a perfect size pan. This is about 8 inches, I would think. And I'm going to place it in the fridge. And you want to use a tray to do that. If you're going to hold on to the pan, you might sort of jiggle it. So it's been 6 hours. It has cooled down in the fridge. I have inverted it on a board. We are getting the glass dish out and we are going to peel the parchment paper, and you will see what a lovely cake it is. Look at the color of that. Isn't it gorgeous?
and shiny. Now you might see a few folds of the parchment paper, and the way to get them out, if you want to, is to use a warm spatula, which is what I've done. I've heated it on the gas, even out all those folds. Here I have a small tea strainer into which I have put some more of the cocoa powder, about a teaspoon, and you're going to tap on the strainer so that you get this dusting of cocoa powder, which makes it look even more decadent. And look at the texture. Look how jiggly and whatever it is. Look at one more slice. Oh, wow. Isn't that gorgeous? If you want a clean cut, just warm your knife a little bit and then try to cut it. It's got an intense taste of dark chocolate. It's also pretty heavy and filling, so you don't need to eat large servings. And this made about 10 to 12 good servings. So it's extremely low carb and absolutely delicious. I hope you guys try it out and let me know in the comments.
I hope you guys enjoyed watching the recipe and will definitely give it a try. If you do, let me know in the comments section. I also share pictures on Instagram and Facebook and sometimes on Twitter. So go follow me there. And thanks for watching. Bye.